The multi-resolution modifier is your best friend when it comes to sculpting and performance. Similarly to the subdivision surface modifier, it allows you to subdivide a mesh. The difference is that you can edit the new subdivision levels in sculpt mode, and you can also switch between the different levels of detail. Even if the use cases are limited to performance, there is hardly a model that did not make use of this modifier when it was created. For example, it is often used after retopology to create a detailed high-poly version of a model. The underlying algorithms allow you to sculpt even the tiniest details. Another use case is for animation. You can animate with a low subdivision level to gain performance, but render your model in full detail by adjusting the levels for the viewport and render correctly. The different levels of subdivision can also be used to export your model in different level of detail, so-called LODs, for a game engine. The multi-resolution modifier has just a few important properties. You can create levels of subdivision here, and adjust the levels of subdivision for the viewport, sculpt mode and render separately. The last one I will show you in just a few moments. As other modifiers, the multi-resolution modifier has some things you must pay attention to. First, the multi-resolution modifier works by saving adjustments separately without affecting the base mesh. When used to create a high-poly version of your retopologized model, you sometimes get into situations where you want to change the underlying geometry. When you go into edit mode and do adjustments there, you will break your mesh most of the time. In sculpt mode, you can enable the checkbox Sculpt Base Mesh. This will propagate your adjustments down to your base model. Second, sometimes you tend to overdo it a bit with the details when sculpting. You see this when your surface suddenly starts to show artifacts like you see here. To get rid of them, you can use the Multires Displacement Eraser to clean up your subdivision topology before you give it another go. Third, since the multi-resolution modifier is special when it comes to order, you sometimes have to apply your modifiers in the wrong order, which can cause your model to break. One example is the multi-resolution and mirror. To fix this, you can apply your modifiers in the correct order, including your multi-resolution. Add the multi-resolution again and use rebuilt subdivisions under generate to bring the subdivisions back to your model.